He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
So last time we talked about what discipleship is. We learned about salvation and discipleship. Like salvation is something you cannot earn by yourself, and you cannot sacrifice anything. It's free and it's a gift. And discipleship, you have to give something, you have to sacrifice something. Jesus had suffered a lot in his own life, like sacrificed a lot to live the life that he lived. And this time we're going to learn the continuation of the same chapter, and the question that we're starting off is, why live like Jesus? So there are a lot of reasons to live like Jesus, but earning God's love is in one of the reasons. So I'm going to learn the reasons why live like Jesus. So there are like three basic reasons to answers to this question, like why live like Jesus. So the first reason is sin. So sin is, first of all, sin is harmful and it is self-destructive. Means it can destroy you, it not only harms us, but it harms people around us. Some examples are like alcoholism, drugs, all that not only harm yourself but your environment. So it destroys lives and belongs to the world. So all this is not part of God or what God wants. It belongs to the world. And it's one of the pleasures that the world offers through sin. So sin and all these pleasures that's offered through the world is temporary. Means it won't last forever and has no enduring value. So right now when you talk to someone, they say like this culture tells us live life, enjoy yourself, be happy and satisfy your happiness, and there's nothing else that matters. But this concept, there's no eternal perspective. These people who talk like that don't know they only focus on this current life in the world. They don't know anything about, or they don't focus on the eternal perspective. And they don't care what happens after this life. So that basically they're focused on this world which is temporary. So let's go to 1 John chapter 2. John chapter 2 verse 15. Can you read 15 to 17?
Do not love the world or things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away, and the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever.
So here we see that talks about the world, and it says don't love the things of the world or the world itself, and anyone who loves it or the love of the Father is not in him. Because the world is temporary and it's all going to go away soon. So that's the first reason for living, like Jesus. The first reason is sin. So the second reason is because living like Jesus, it blesses others. So that's the second reason. So this reason is opposite of the first reason, because first reason was sin, and we learned that it harms yourself and others around. But this second one is the opposite. It blesses others. So the basically the way we think, it either blesses other people or it curses them. So for example, Jesus, he served people and he was a blessing to other people. And blessing people not only reflects Jesus, but it's personally fulfilling. So that's the second reason, which is blessing other people. The third reason is it allows us to be consistent witness of the gospel. So first reason was sin, the second reason was it blesses other people, and third is it allows you to be a witness of the gospel. So if people don't see the difference between you and the people or the world, it'll be hard for them to believe the gospel, because people expect us to live like Jesus, like in the Bible, and they might see our lives as a contradiction to the gospel if we don't live like that. So it isn't about earning a place in heaven. So that was the third reason, which was being a witness of the gospel. So the three reasons were sin, and then it blesses others, and then the third one is it allows us to be a consistent witness of the gospel. So those are the three reasons to live like Jesus. So let's go through some scriptures. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Chapter 1-2. Verse 1-2.
I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good.
So that was Romans chapter 12, verse 1-2. Now let's go to 2 Timothy. Chapter 2, verse 19. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19. verse 19 to 21.
Nevertheless, this solid foundation of God's stands, having the sea, the Lord knows there were others, and let anyone whose name, in the name of Christ, depart in pity. In a great house there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of gold and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor.
Till verse 21.
Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself or from the litter, that he will be a vessel of honor, sanctified and useful of the master's prepared for every good work.
Now let's go to Timothy chapter 2, verse 19 to 21. Now let's go to Philippians chapter 2. Philippians chapter 2. Chapter 2. Chapter 2, verse 1. Philippians verse 4 to 8. Dying read from verse 1 to 4. Can we call it from 4 to 8? Verse 4 to 8. Same. No, verse 4 to 8. The same chapter. Philippians chapter 2, verse 14.
Let each of you look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interests of others. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bond servant and coming in the likeness of men and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross.
So these three things have been read, it gives us an idea of how we should live. But we're learning about discipleship, and it's still not specifically speaking about discipleship. So how do disciples live? What do they do? But Jesus and his disciples had already made the answers to these questions. So Jesus never told his followers to do something he didn't do himself, and he showed them how to do it. So his disciples followed his example, and he taught others to do the same. So he never made his disciples do anything that he didn't do. This is all for this chapter. We'll learn the next chapter called What Does a Disciple Do Next Sunday. Thank you for this time you've given us. Thank you for helping me teaching them and helping them to understand. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.